Hello guys, good morning. Dear all participants, our online lecture starts now. Respected leaders and teachers, scholars and students, welcome to our second section, Wastewater Treatment, based on the zero lecture on the application of water treatment technology in China. This online event is arranged and organized by Simultech, School of Equipment and Environment, Guangxi Polytechnic and Construction, China Excellent Construction Talent Training Base, and of course, co-organized by Go Study Global Education. And we are so honored and pleased to have Ms. Yang Wenting with us today as our speaker. So please allow me to do a very brief and short introduction of Ms. Yang. Ms. Yang Wenting is an associate professor in the School of Equipment and Environment. Also an elite teacher of water supply and drainage engineering technology. He has a master's degree majoring in engineering, and as a senior engineer, she also an expert of Guangxi Standardization Association. And now please, let's welcome Ms. Yang.
Hello,大家好，今天我们一起学习中国水处理技术应用与发展二污水处理。我是今天的主讲教师杨文婷。
Good morning, everyone. Today we will learn about the application and development of water treatment technology in China. Second, wastewater treatment. I am Yang Wenting, the teacher of today's lecture.
我将从以下几个方面来进行讲述今天的内容：一、污水处理技术历史；二、污水处理方法和工艺流程；三、应用案例；四、污水处理新技术。
I introduce today's content from the following slides. First, the history of wastewater treatment technology. Second, wastewater treatment methods and process. Third, application cases. And fourth, new wastewater treatment technologies.
污水处理历史可以追溯到公元九世纪初，那个时期环境容量大，水体的自净能力已经能够满足人类的用水需求。
The history of wastewater can be traced back to the early 9th century AD, when environmental capacity was large and the self-purification capacity of water bodies was able to meet the water demand of human beings.
人们仅需考虑排水问题即可，而后伴随城市化进程加快，生活污水通过传播细菌引发了传染病的蔓延。
The people then only need to consider that it's changed the issues. Subsequently, with the accelerated urbanization process, the mass wastewater caused by the spread of infectious diseases through the dissemination of bacteria.
出于健康的考虑，人类开始对排放的生活污水进行处理。
For health reasons, humans have begun to treat the discharged domestic wastewater.
16世纪中期，我国已采用石灰。 明矾等沉淀及漂白粉消毒，对污水进行净化。
In the mid-16th century, China has used lime, alum, and other precipitation and bleaching powder desalination to purify wastewater.
1881年，法国科学家发明了第一座生物反应器，也是第一座厌氧生物处理池，Morris 池诞生，拉开了生物法处理污水的序幕。
1881, French scientists invented the first anaerobic bioreactor treatment pool, the porous pool, which opened the prelude to biological wastewater treatment.
19世纪，发达国家已经普及二级生物处理技术，先后出现了活性污泥等各种类型的生物处理法等。
In the 19th century, secondary biological treatment technology has been popularized in developed countries, and various types of biological treatment methods, such as atomic sludge, have emerged.
至今，污水处理技术从20世纪60年代的末端治理到70年代的防治结合。
up to now, wastewater treatment technology has been developed rapidly with the continuous upgrade of treatment process technology, facilities, and equipment. For example, from the end treatment in 1960s to decontamination of prevention and controls in the 1970s.
从80年代的集中治理到90年代的清洁生产，不断更新治理工艺技术、设施和设备。
From centralized treatment in the 1980s to clean production in 1990s, the technology has been upgrading continuously.
目前，污水生物处理技术的主要发展趋势是多种技术组合为一体的新技术、新工艺。
At present, the main development trend of wastewater biological treatment technology is the combination of multiple technologies into a new technology and a new process.
水污染治理的目标已经由传统意义上的污水处理达标排放，转变为以水之再生为核心的水的循环再利用，由单纯的污染控制上升为水生态修复。
The goal of water pollution control has changed from the traditional wastewater treatment for discharge that meets standard requirements to water recycling and reuse with water quality regeneration at the core, and from simple pollution control to water ecological restoration.
污水主要有工业污水、生活污水、生产污水、农业污水这四个来源。
Wastewater mainly comes from four sources: industrial wastewater, domestic wastewater, production wastewater, and agricultural wastewater.
目前，中国的城镇污水日处理能力由2010年的 1.2 亿吨增加到 1.82 亿吨，已成为全世界污水处理能力最大的国家之一。
1 million tons in 2010 to 182 million tons, making it one of the countries with the largest wastewater treatment capacity in the world.
污水水质指标，各种受污染水中污染物质的最高容许浓度或限量法的具体形式和要求，是判断水污染程度的具体衡量尺度。
Wastewater quality indicators mean the specific limits and requirements for the maximum allowable concentration or limit threshold of various pollutions.In the polluted water, and their specific measures for judging the degree of water pollution.
直接、间接反映水的性质，综合评价水体质量，对水质进行界定分类。
They reflect the nature of water directly or indirectly, and are used to comprehensively evaluate water quality, define and classify water quality.
那么，如何实现我们的排放目标呢？
So, how do we achieve?The emissions targets.
为了保障人体健康，维护生态平衡，促进国民经济和城乡建设的发展。
In order to promote human health, maintain ecological balance, and promote the development of the national economy and urban and rural construction.
中国出台的国家标准《城镇污水厂污染物排放标准》规定了城镇污水处理厂出水。废气排放和污泥处理控制的污染物限值。
China has issued a national standard pollutant discharge standard for urban wastewater treatment plants, which sets pollutant limits for the treated wastewater, exhaust gas emissions, and sludge disposal or control of urban wastewater treatment plants.
该标准适用于城镇污水处理厂出水、废气排放。和污泥处置控制的管理。
This standard is applicable to the management of treated wastewater, exhaust gas emissions, and sludge disposal or control in urban wastewater treatment plants.
居民小区和工业企业内独立的生活污水处理设施污染物的排放管理也按该标准执行。
The discharge management of pollutants.From independent domestic wastewater treatment facilities in residential areas and industrial areas is also in accordance with this standard.
中国在习近平总书记的领导下提出推动绿色发展、促进人与自然和谐共生的要求， 践行新时代生态文明发展观。
Under the leadership of Xi Jinping, the General Secretary of CPC Central Committee, China proposed the idea of promoting green development and the harmonious coexistence between man and nature, and practiced the development concept of ecological civilization for the new era.
指出，我们追求人与自然的和谐，经济与社会的和谐。
It is pointed out that what we pursue is the harmony between man and nature.And harmony between economy and society.
通俗的讲，就是要两座山，既要金山银山，又要绿水青山。绿水青山就是金山银山。
Generally speaking, what we want is two mountains, the Golden Mountain and Silver Mountain. Now that the lucid wastewaters and lush mountains are invaluable assets, and green waters and green mountains are Golden Mountains and Silver Mountains.
中国在生态可持续发展方面很下功夫，近年来取得了卓越的成效。
China has made great efforts in ecological sustainable development and has achieved remarkable results in recent years.
以中国广西南宁为例，在短短的三年内，南宁建成12个污水处理厂，全部通水调试运行。
Taking Nanning, Guangxi, China as an example, in just 3 years, Nanning has completed 12 wastewater plants, all of which have been put into operation after commissioning.
新增污水处理能力86万吨每日，完成污水管网建设645公里，38个黑臭河段消除黑臭。
With an additional wastewater treatment capacity of 860,000 tons per day, completed the construction of 645 kilometers of wastewater pipeline network and eliminated 38 polluted and odious river sections.
全市污水收集处理能力快速提升，城市水环境质量达到全国领先水平。
The city's wastewater collection and treatment capacity has rapidly improved, and the quality of urban water environment has reached the national leading level.
那什么是污水处理呢？
So, what is wastewater treatment?
污水处理主要是采用各种技术与手段，将污水中所含的污染物分离去除、回收利用。
Wastewater treatment mainly use various technologies and means to separate, remove, or recycle.
或将其转化为无害物质，使水得到净化。
Or convert pollutants contained in wastewater into harmless, sustainable substances to purify water.
目的是资源的回收和再利用及生态保护。
The purpose is to recover and reuse resources and protect.The ecological environment.
物理化学处理法
Physical treatment method and chemical treatment method.
城镇污水处理的方法依据污水处理原理分为一物理处理法
Based on the principles of wastewater treatment, urban wastewater treatment methods are divided into the following aspects. First, physical treatment method.
物理处理法主要用于分离和去除水中的不溶性悬浮物和固体方法，包括筛滤、沉淀、气浮、过滤等。
This method is mainly used to separate and remove insoluble suspended solids in solids in water, including screening, sedimentation, air flotation, filtration, etc.
二、物理化学处理法。
Second, physical and chemical treatment method.
物理化学处理法用来分离去除污水中呈溶解胶体状态的污染物或将其转化为无害物质的方法。
This method is a method used to separate, remove, dissolve, and collide pollutants in wastewater or convert them into harmless substances.
包括中和、混凝、电解、氧化还原等。
Including neutralization, coagulation, electrolysis, oxidation, diffusion, etc.
生物化学处理法。
Biochemical treatment method.
生物化学处理法是利用微生物的代谢作用，使水中呈溶解和胶体状态的有机污染物转化为无害物质，以实现净化的方法。
Which is a method that uses the metabolic action of microorganisms to convert dissolved and colloidal organic pollutants in water into harmless substances to achieve purification.
分为耗氧生物处理法和厌氧生物处理法。
It is divided into aerobic biological treatments and anaerobic biological treatment.
其中耗氧生物处理法又包括活性污泥法、生物膜法、自然生物处理法等。
Among them, aerobic biological treatment methods include activated sludge method, biofilm method, natural biological treatment method, etc.
将上述物理处理、物理化学处理、生物处理法结合起来对污水进行处理，使其出水达到标准。
Combine the above physical treatments, physical and chemical treatment, and biological treatment methods to treat wastewater to meet the standards for treated water.
从处理深度来分类，主要有三级。
There are mainly three levels in terms of the depth of treatment.
首先是一级处理，一般采用物理的方法，如隔山、筛网、沉沙池、沉淀池对大颗粒悬浮物进行拦截或沉淀。
The first is primary treatment, which generally uses physical methods such as grids, screens, grid chambers, and sedimentation pools to intercept or precipitate large particulate suspended solids.
接下来到二级处理，一般采用生物处理，如活性污泥、生物滤池、生物转盘。对溶解态和胶体状态的杂质进行吸收或降解。
The next is the secondary treatment, wherein biological treatment is generally used, such as activated sludge, biological filter pool, and biological rotary stable to absorb or degrade, dissolve and colloidal impurities.
最后是三级处理，又称深度处理。它将一级、二级处理中难降解的营养物质和有机物质通过物理化学的方法。
The final is the tertiary treatment, also known as advanced treatment, which removes nutrient, which uses the method to remove physical and chemical methods.
如混凝沉淀、过滤、氧化还原、活性炭吸附等方法去除。最终使出水达标。
Such as coagulation and sedimentation, filtration, oxidation and reduction, as well as activated carbon absorptions to ultimately make the discharge of treated wastewater meet the requirements of relevant standards or codes.
城镇的污水综合典型处理工艺流。水经过隔山，去除尺寸比较大的杂质。
The wastewater post passes through a grid, remove relatively large impurities.
再经由水泵提升至沉沙池，去除无机沙粒等大颗粒物质。
And then it's lifted.By a water pump to a grid chamber to remove large particles such as inorganic gravels.
接着进入初次沉淀池，沉淀掉有机颗粒污染物质后。
Then the wastewater enters the primary sedimentation pool to remove large organic particles.
来到生物处理的爆气池，去除可溶解的有机污染物。
And come to the biological treatment action pool to remove soluble organic pollutants.
最后，经过二次沉淀池，将污泥沉淀出水，最终排入河流或回用。
And finally, the activated sludge is precipitated through a secondary sedimentation pool, and treated wastewater is eventually discharged into a river or reused.
其中，初沉池和二沉池的污泥经过污泥浓缩、污泥消化、污泥脱水后，进入污泥资源回收。
The sludge from the primary and the secondary sedimentation pool undergoes sludge concentration, digestion, and dehydration before it is recovered as resource.
接下来，我们详细讲讲每一道工艺的具体流程和原理。
Next, we'll talk about the specific process and principles of each process in detail.
格栅的原理主要是塞滤。
The working principle of the grid relies in its sieve filtration.
塞滤是去除废水中粗大的悬浮物和杂质，以保护后续处理设施能正常运行的一种预处理方法。
Sieve filtration is a pre-treatment method for removing coarse suspended silics and debris from wastewater to protect the normal operation of the subsequent treatment facilities.
塞滤的构件包括平行的棒、条、金属网、隔网或穿孔板。
The components of the sieve filtration include parallel rods, bars, metal meshes, and grids or perforated plates.
其中由平行的棒和条构成的称为隔栅，由金属丝织物或穿孔板构成的称为塞网。
Wherein the grid is composed of a parallel rods and bars, a mass made of metal wire fabric or perforated plates is called a sieve.
其中，粗格栅去除的是那些可能堵塞水泵机组及管道阀门较粗大的悬浮物。
The coarse grids remove larger suspended solids that may clog the pump units and pipeline valves.
而细格栅去除的是用粗格栅难以去除的呈悬浮状的细小纤维。
And the fine grids remove suspended fine fibers that are difficult to remove with grids.
沉淀是指水中的悬浮物依靠重力的作用从水中分离出来的过程。
Sedimentation, which refers to the process of separating suspended solids from water by gravity,
是一种物理过程，简单易行，效果良好，是污水处理的重要技术之一。
It is a simple and effective physical process, and is one of the important technologies for wastewater treatment.
应用沉淀过程的主要构筑物有沉沙池、沉淀池、气浮池。澄清池等。
The main structures used in the sedimentation process include grid chambers, sedimentation pools, air flotation pools, clarification pools, etc.
沉沙池用来去除比重较大的无机颗粒，如泥沙、煤渣、悬浮物等。
The grid chamber is used to remove inorganic particles with a relatively large specific gravity, such as sediment, coal, cinder, suspended solids.
避免这些杂质影响后续构筑物正常运行，减轻机械管道的磨损。
To avoid impurities affecting the normal operation of subsequent structures and to reduce the wear and tear of machinery and pipelines.
初沉池可以去除有机颗粒。降低生物处理构筑物的有机负荷。
The primary sedimentation pool can remove organic particles to reduce the organic load on biological treatment structures.
格栅和沉沙池可以去除污水中 20% 的污染物质。
The grids and grid chambers can remove 20% of the pollutants in wastewater.
作为污水生物处理，爆气池污染物的去除率可高达 80% 到 90%。
As a biological treatment of wastewater, the removal rate of pollutants in an aeration pool can be as high as 80 to 90%。
爆气池是利用活性污泥进行污水处理的构筑物。
Aeration pool is a process that artificially enhances the degradation of structures for natural treatment.
活性污泥也就是微生物，微生物的生长需要食物和氧气，食物就是污染物。
Activated sludge is a constant kind of microorganisms whose growth requires oxygen and fluids, which are organic pollutants.
爆气池利用鼓风和爆气设备为微生物提供适宜的氧气。
Aeration pools use air blowing and aeration equipment to provide suitable oxygen for microorganisms.
创造有利于微生物生长繁殖的良好环境，使水中有机污染物得以降解去除。
Which is to create a good environment conducive to the growth and reproduction of microorganisms, improve the rate of microbial degradation of pollutants, and enable the degradation and removal of organic pollutants in water.
在温度适宜、溶解氧充足，而且不存在有毒有害抑制物质的条件下。
Under the conditions of suitable temperature, sufficient dissolved oxygen, and the absence of toxic and harmful inhibitory substances,
污染物和微生物数量平衡，爆气池内生态环境保持稳定运行。
The amount of pollutants and microorganisms is balanced, and the ecological environment in the aeration pool maintains stable.
在这里主要去除了 80% 左右水中呈溶解态和胶体态的有机污染物。
Here, about 80% of organic pollutants in the dissolved and colloidal form in the water are mainly removed.
当爆气池中的微生物经历生长、繁殖、死亡，需要将这部分的污泥排出系统外。
The microorganisms in the aeration pool experience growth, reproduction, and death, and it is necessary to discharge this part of sludge out of the system to maintain operational balance.
需要设置后续的二层池，将会实现污水和污泥的分离。
The secondary dissemination pool that needs to be set up subsequently will achieve the separation of wastewater and sludge.
分离后的污水已经达到排放标准，通过消毒后可以排放水体或进行回用。
The separated wastewater has met the standard for discharge and can be discharged into the water body or reused after disinfection.
如有更高的出水要求或具有更好的技术能力，可以进一步进行深度处理。
If there are higher requirements for discharge of treated wastewater or better technical requirements or capacities, further advanced treatment can be carried out.
分离后的污泥一部分回流到出层池和爆气池。
A portion of the separated sludge flows back to the primary sedimentation pool and aeration pool.
以恢复活性污泥的降解和代谢能力。
To restore the degradation and metabolic capacity of the activated sludge.
另一部分污泥经过污泥浓缩、污泥消化、污泥脱水等工艺后。
The other sludge after thickening, digestion, and dehydration.
不能直接弃用，因为会存在污染风险。
They can't be directly discarded because there is risk of pollution.
可以将污泥进行处理和处置后，将污泥资源回收或用作肥料。
After treatment of the sludge, it can be recycled or used as fertilizers.
那么接下来，我们将对具有典型代表意义的一些先进污水处理技术的工程项目与大家进一步学习。
Next, we will further study with you some typical advanced wastewater treatment technology in the engineering projects.
第一个案例是中国西南区域的大规模污水处理厂，广西南宁市江南污水处理厂。
The first case is a large-scale wastewater treatment plant in South China, Southwest China, the Jiangnan Wastewater Treatment Plant in Nanning, Guangxi.
占地面积623亩，污水处理总规模为96万立方米每日，具备72万立方米每天的处理能力，是目前广西规模最大的污水处理厂。
Which covers an area of 623 mu, about 41.5 hectares, with a total designed daily capacity of wastewater treatment 960,000 cubic meters, being capable of treating 720,000 cubic meters wastewater per day so far. It is currently the largest wastewater treatment plant in Guangxi.
该厂主要负责接纳处理城市五大流域的污水。
Which is mainly responsible for receiving and treating wastewater from the five major urban basins.
同时，江南污水处理厂还是一座向公众开放的集科学实验、环保教育及休闲娱乐于一体的科普教育基地。
Meanwhile, the plant is also a popular science education base open to the public.That integrates scientific experiments, environmental protection, education, leisure, and entertainment.
向公众宣传绿色的水处理知识，倡导绿色发展理念，为城市建设、经济社会可持续发展及建设区域性国际城市做出积极贡献。
The plan promotes green water treatment technology to the public.Advocates the concept of green development and makes positive contributions to urban construction, sustainable economic and social development, and the construction of a regional national city.
中国江南污水处理厂先进的处理工艺使出水达到城镇污水处理厂水污染排放标准。GB 18918-2002 一级 A 排放标准。
The advanced treatment process of Jiangnan Wastewater Treatment Plant in China has enabled the treated wastewater to meet the discharge standard specified in the discharge standard for water pollutants from urban wastewater treatment plants GB 18918-2002.
进一步增加黑臭水体综合治理能力，改善相关流域的水质状态，促进生态文明建设。
Which further increases the comprehensive treatment capacity of black and odorous wastewater bodies, improving the water quality of relevant waste streams, and promoting the development of ecological construction.
其中极具示范性的有改良 AAO 工艺。
Among them, the improved AAO process is highly exemplary.
深度处理工艺主要采用深层滤池工艺。
The advanced treatment process mainly uses the deep bed filter pool process.
污泥系统调理单元主要采用以生物调理为主的生物滤净系统。
The sludge system conditioning unit mainly uses.The biological leaching system that focuses on biological conditioning.
脱水单元主要采用板宽机脱水。
The dehydration unit mainly uses the plate and frame machine for dehydration.
传统意义的 AAO 生物脱氮除磷工艺由厌氧、缺氧、耗氧三个反应器组成。
The traditional AAO, biological nitrogen and phosphorus removal process, consists of three reactors, aerobic, anaerobic, and aerobic reactors.
液氧池主要功能是由嗜磷菌释放磷，同时对部分有机物进行氨化。
The main function of the aerobic pool is to release phosphorus by phosphorus-releasing bacteria while ammoniating some organic matters.
缺氧池主要功能是脱氮，将内回流带回的硝酸盐、亚硝酸盐通过生物反消化作用转化成氮气排放空气中。
The main function of the anoxic pool is to remove nitrogen, converting the nitrate and nitrite returned from the internal influx into nitrogen through biological denitrification and discharge the nitrogen into air.
耗氧池聚磷菌超量吸收磷，并通过剩余污泥的排放将磷去除。
The phosphorus accumulating bacteria in the aerobic pool absorb excessive phosphorus and remove it through the discharge of the surface sludge.
而江南污水处理厂在对以上传统工艺进行改造，设计为出水水质卓越的改良型 AO 生物池，作为生化处理的主要构筑物，是污水处理厂的核心部分。
The Jiangnan Wastewater Treatment Plant, transforming the above traditional process, adopts the design of an improved AAO biological pool with excellent treated wastewater quality as the main structure for biochemical treatment, which is the core of the wastewater treatment plant.
它采用了多点净水工艺，分别位于液氧区、第一缺氧区及第二缺氧区。
It adopts the process of multi-point water inflows located respectively in the aerobic zone, the first and the second aerobic zone.
强化了脱氮除磷工况，实际出水指标优于一级 A 指标。
Enhance the nitrogen and phosphorus removal conditions. The actual discharge indexes of treated wastewater are superior to that of class 1A.
其对冲击负荷及水量负荷的能力、除碳脱氮能力都相当优秀。
Its ability to withstand impact loads and water loads, as well as its carbon and nitrogen removal capacities, are outstanding.
另一项引领全国的先进技术是生床滤池。生床滤池目前仅作为去除 SS 的深度处理构筑物。
Another advanced technology leading the country is deep bed filter pool, which is currently used only as an advanced treatment structure for SS removal.
在设计滤数之下，能完全满足深度处理对 SS 总氮、总磷的去除要求。
Under the design filtration rate, it can fully meet the removal requirements of SS, TP, TN for advanced treatment.
对于大气保护方面，江南污水处理厂的除臭技术也是非常值得一提。
In terms of atmospheric protection, the deodorization technology of Jiangnan Wastewater Treatment Plant is also worth mentioning.
离子加生物土壤除臭技术采用离子加生物土壤除臭法作为除臭手段。
The iron plus biological soil deodorization technology uses iron plus biological soil deodorization method for deodorization.
双离子除臭法主要是利用高压静电装置，在常温常压下将臭气分解成二氧化碳、水。
The dual iron deodorization method mainly adopts high voltage electrostatic devices to decompose odor into carbon dioxide and water under normal temperature and pressure.
它能有效地清除空气中的细菌、 可吸入颗粒物、硫化合物等有害物质。
It can effectively remove harmful substances such as bacteria, inhalable particles, and sulfur compounds from the air.
另外是生物粒径污泥调理技术，江南污水处理厂生物粒径法污泥深度脱水技术。
In addition, there is the biological leaching sludge conditioning technology. Jiangnan Wastewater Treatment Plant has adopted the advanced biological leaching sludge dehydration technology.
是国内外首次成功实现工程化应用的新型微生物污泥处理技术。
It is the first successful engineering application of a new type of microbial sludge treatment technology at home and abroad.
该工艺为全国最大剩余污泥经生物粒径板宽压滤深度脱水后含水率均可稳定在 60% 以下。
This process has the largest capacity in China. After biological leaching and deep dehydration by plate and frame pressure filtration, the moisture content of the remaining sludge can be stabilized below 60%.
泥饼呈土黄色。臭味大幅度降低，有机质含量基本不变。
The mud cake is yellowish brown with a significantly reduced odor, while the organic matter content is basically unchanged.
同时，生物粒径深度脱水污泥的有机质及热值得到完好保留。
Meanwhile,The organic matter and calorific value of the deeply dehydrated sludge with biological leaching are well preserved.
由于不添加石灰，对后续耗氧发酵、土地利用及水泥窑协同焚烧的处理方式均无影响。
Due to the absence of lime, there is no impact on subsequent aerobic fermentation, land use,and synergistic combustion in cement kilns.
第二个想要给大家分享的案例是中国奇迹武汉火神山污水处理。
The second case I want to share with you is the Chinese miracle, Wuhan 火神山 wastewater treatment project.
十天时间，从设计到交工，火神山医院拔地而起，展现了世界第一的中国速度。
火神山 Hospital has sprung up in 10 days from design to completion, demonstrating China's speed to the world, which is the fastest speed around the world.
鉴于新型冠状病毒的传染性强，医院的污水处理工艺标准必须高于普通传染病医院。
In view of the strong infectivity of COVID-19, the wastewater treatment plant process standard of hospitals must be higher than that of ordinary infectious disease hospitals.
武汉火神山污水经专用管网收集后，要经过预消毒、化粪池、调节池、接触氧化、沉淀。二次消毒等多道严格的处理工序。
After being collected through a dedicated pipe network, the 火神山 Hospital wastewater project in Wuhan will undergo multiple strict treatment processes such as pre-disinfection, septic tank, regulating pool, contact oxidation, sedimentation, and secondary disinfection.
最终达到中国医疗机构水污染物排放标准要求后排入市政管网。
To finally meet the requirements of China's water pollutant discharge standards for medical institutions before being discharged into the municipal pipe network.
污水处理产生的污泥经浓缩脱水后，由专门的微废处理公司进行集中处理。
The sludge generated from wastewater treatment is concentrated and dehydrated and then centrally treated by a specialized hazardous waste treatment company.
所有的污水处理单元均使用一体化密封设备。污水处理站的臭气经收集、消毒、净化后排放。
All wastewater treatment units use integrated sealing equipment, and the odor from the wastewater treatment station is collected, disinfected, and purified before being discharged.
污水处理站拥有两套独立的污水消毒处理系统，采用两用一备的运行模式。
The wastewater treatment station has two independent wastewater disinfection and treatment systems, with two working and the other standby.
在一组系统发生故障或进行检修时，另有一组系统可以正常运行。每组系统的处理能力都可以满足现场要求。
When one system fails or undergoes maintenance, the other one can operate normally, and the processing capacity of each system can meet the actual requirements on the site.
同时，为了守住疫情防控底线，滴水不漏。
Meanwhile, in order to maintain the bottom line of the pandemic prevention and control as totally watertight,
火神山医院的废水从排出到处理合格要经过七道严格的工序。
The wastewater from 火神山 Hospital needs to undergo seven strict processes from discharge to qualified treatment.
HDPE 膜为火神山医院2.5万平方米的地下基础穿上了防护服。
The HDPE film is used to wear protective clothing for the 25,000 square meters underground foundation of the 火神山 Hospital.
医院区域的雨水也会单独收集，统一消毒。
The rainwater in the hospital area is also collected separately and disinfected on centralized basis.
医疗废水与雨水得到妥善处理，不会让一滴污水进入地下，污染周围土壤和水体。
Medical wastewater and rainwater are properly treated to prevent a drop of wastewater from entering the ground and contaminating surrounding soil and water bodies.
中国在进行城镇化建设的同时，也考虑了乡村建设发展。
While carrying out urbanization, China has also made great efforts in the development of rural construction.
目前实施的乡村振兴战略中，中国广西美丽南方新农村污水处理是中国第一批示范性山水田湖林生命共同体项目。
Under the current rural revitalization strategy,The Beautiful South New Rural Wastewater Treatment Plant Project in Guangxi, China, is one of the first batch of demonstration projects in China as landscape, farmland, lake and forest common life community.
美丽南方属于国家级田园综合体项目区。
The Beautiful South is located in the National Pastoral Complex Project Area.
鳞次栉比的青砖白墙民居，小桥流水，亭台池塘的自然美景。
With rows of folk houses of green tile and white wall, small bridges with flowing water beneath, and natural beauty of pavilions and ponds.
让人第一眼就能感受到这里惬意的田园生活气息。
People can feel the present rural life here.At the first glance,
除了田园风光，这里还能体验骑马、卡丁车、垂钓、采摘等休闲活动。
In addition to the idyllic scenery, one can also experience leisure activities such as horse riding, karting, fishing, and fruit picking.
2017年以来，以美丽南方片区农村黑臭水体及坑塘沟渠水环境综合治理工作为抓手。
Since 2017, the comprehensive treatment of rural black and odorous water bodies and the water environment of pits, ponds, and ditches in and around the area of the beautiful South have served as a starting point,
深入开展山水林田湖草生态修复工程。
Projects of the ecological restoration of mountains, rivers, forests, fields, lakes, and grasses have been carried out.
同步推进农村黑臭水体治理、农村生活污水治理及农村水环境生态修复工作。
And the treatment of rural black and odorous water bodies, rural domestic wastewater treatments, and ecological restoration of rural water environment have been promoted.
梅利南方片区农村生态环境得到有效修复和改善。
The rural ecological environment in and around the beautiful South has been effectively repaired and improved.
人居环境明显提升，为落实乡村振兴战略，打造看得见山、望得到水、记得住乡愁的乡村景观，奠定了坚实的基础。
So has the living environment. This has laid a solid foundation for implementing the rural revitalization strategy and creating a rural landscape that people can see the mountains and waters and be reminded of nostalgia.
也为削减流域污染负荷，保障饮水安全以及左右江流域和生态安全发挥了积极作用。
It has also played a positive role in reducing the pollution of the river basin, ensuring the safety of drinking water, and the ecological safety of the Zhejiang and Youjiang river basins.
就我国目前的污水处理现状而言，污水处理技术市场需求相当大。
Regarding the current situation of wastewater treatment in China, the wastewater treatment technology has a large market demand.
城市污水处理的发展趋势将表现为以下几个方面的特点。
The development trend of urban wastewater treatment will be characterized by the following aspects.
一、氮磷、营养物质的去除仍为重点，也是难点。
First,The removal of nitrogen and phosphorus nutrients is still a key and difficult point.
二，工业废水治理开始转向全过程控制。
Second, industrial wastewater treatment begins to require the whole process control.
三，单独分散处理转为城市污水集中处理。
Third, separate decentralized treatment has been turned on to centralized treatment of urban wastewater.
四、水质控制指标越来越严。
Four, water quality control indicators are becoming increasingly stringent.
五、由单纯工艺技术转向工艺、设备、工程综合集成产业化及经济、政策、标准综合性研究。
Fifth, The research simply on process technology has been shifted to the integrated industrialization of process, equipment, and engineering, as well as comprehensive research on economy, policies, and standards.
六，污水再生利用日益受到重视。
Six, increasing attention has been paid to wastewater recycling and utilization.
七，污泥处理处置问题亟待解决。
Seven,The problems of sludge treatment and disposal needs to be solved urgently.
八、中小城镇及农村水污染与治理问题受到重视。
Eight, attention has been paid to the issues of water pollution and treatment in small and medium-sized towns and rural areas.
新的技术发展热点有。
New technology development hotspots include.
降低污水厂能耗，污水处理厂的能耗占污水处理厂运行维护成本的30%-80%。
Reducing energy consumption in wastewater treatment plants. The energy consumption of wastewater treatment plants accounts for 30%-80% of the operation and maintenance costs of wastewater plants.
过高的能耗严重阻碍了我国城镇污水处理厂的建设与管理， 因此降低能耗是污水处理厂未来发展的必由之路。
Excessive energy consumption has seriously hindered the construction and management of urban wastewater treatment plants in China. Therefore, reducing energy consumption is a must for the future development of wastewater treatment plants.
城镇污水处理厂其能耗大体可以分为污水提升泵、爆气系统、机械搅拌、污泥回流泵、污泥脱水等电耗，以及污泥消化头加的热能等。
The energy consumption of urban wastewater treatment plants can be generally divided into the power consumption of wastewater lift pumps, aeration systems, mechanical agitation, sludge reflux pumps, sludge dehydration, and heat energy added by sludge digestion.
同时还有通过絮凝剂、外加碳源、氯气、活性炭等一系列外加耗材生产过程中所需要的能量。
Meanwhile, it also includes the energy required by the production of a series of additional consumables such as flocculants, additional carbon sources, chlorine, and activated carbon.
为保护农村水环境，建设美丽乡村和农村生态文明。
In order to protect the rural water environment and to build a beautiful countryside and rural ecological civilization,
国家出台了多个农村环境保护相关政策，农村生态环境治理顶层设计日趋完善。
China has issued a number of policies related to rural environment protection, and the top-level design of rural ecological environment governance has been improved significantly.
农业农村现代化迈出新步伐，对新时代新阶段的农业农村现代生态环境治理建设具有重要的指导意义。
New progress has been made in the modernization of agriculture and rural areas.Which carries important guiding significance for the construction of modern ecological environment governance in agriculture and rural areas on the new stage for the new area.
海绵城市是新一代城市雨洪管理概念。
Sponge city is a concept of rainwater and flood management for the cities in a new generation.
是指城市能够像海绵一样在适应环境变化和应对雨水带来的自然灾害等方面具有良好的弹性。
Which refers to the ability and resilience of cities to adapt to the environmental changes and respond to natural disasters through what about rain-like sponges.
也可称之为水弹性城市。
It can also be called a water resilient city.
在新形势下，海绵城市是推动绿色建筑建设。
In the new situation, sponge cities are conducive to building the construction of green cities.
低碳城市发展，智慧城市形成的创新表现。
And low carbon city development and the formation of smart cities.
是新时代特色背景下现代绿色新技术与社会、环境、人文等多种因素下的有机结合。
They are the organic combination of modern green new technologies and social, environmental, cultural and other factors in the context of the new era.
地下综合管廊是建设在城市地下，用于集中辐射电力、通信、广播电视、给水等市政管线的公共隧道。
The underground comprehensive pipe gallery is a public tunnel built underground in the city for centralized laying of municipal pipelines such as power cables, communication cables, and pipelines for radio, television, and water supply.
地下综合管廊可有效杜绝拉链马路现象。让技术人员无需反复开挖路面。
the underground comprehensive pipe gallery can effectively eliminate the phenomenon of zipper roads, allowing technicians to avoid the repeated excavation of road surface.
在管廊中就可对各类管线进行抢修、维护、扩容改造等，同时大大缩减管线抢修时间。
The emergency repair, the maintenance, expansion, and transformation of various pipe lines can be conducted in the gallery, which greatly reduces the time for pipeline emergency repair.
城市排水信息化管理系统基于物联网理念，采用信息化手段，结合即时展示。
Urban information-based drainage management system, based on the concept of the Internet of Things, using information technology and GIS display.
全面掌握排水系统的运行情况，如管网液位、流量、水质、气体、泵站运行状态等信息，保证排水系统安全高效运行。
Comprehensively grasp the operation status of the drainage system.Such as pipeline level, flow, water quality, gas, and operation status of pump stations to ensure the safe and efficient operation of the drainage system.
通过构建安全预警平台，提高应急指挥及快速处置能力。
Emergency command and rapid handling capacities are improved by building a safety early warning platform.
保障城市排水管线的安全运行，使得整个城市排水管线的安全运行可把握、可控制、可预测。
The safe operation of urban drainage pipelines of the entire city, which is controllable and predictable, provide a scientific basis for this system.
提供科学先进的城市级水利分析模型，全面评估城市排水管网能力。
To provide scientific and advanced urban level hydraulic analysis models for comprehensive evaluation of the capacity of urban drainage network.
以城市排水设施数据为基础，结合管网监测数据、气象雨情信息，为城市排水规划。防涝预测提供决策依据。
Based on the urban drainage facility air data and pipe network monitoring data and meteorological and rain information, it provides decision-making basis for urban drainage planning and flood prevention prediction.
中国共产党在2022年第20次人民代表大会报告指出，中国是现代化。是人与自然和谐共生的现代化。
The report of the 20th People's Congress of the CPC in 2022 pointed out that China's path to modernization is a modernization in which man and nature coexist in harmony.
我们要推进美丽中国建设，坚持山水林田湖草沙一体化保护和系统治理。
We need to promote the construction of beautiful China, adhere to the integrated protection and systematic governance of mountains, forests, farmland, lakes, and grass and sand.
统筹产业结构调整、污染治理、生态保护、应对气候变化，协同推进降碳、减污、扩绿、增长，推进生态优先。节约集约绿色低碳发展。
Coordinate to promote industrial restructuring, pollution control, ecological protection, and address climate change, and to promote carbon reduction, pollution reduction, green expansion, growth, as well as to promote the ecological priority, conservation, intensive development, and green and low carbon development.
悠悠碧水。见证着中国大地在推动绿色发展上实现更大进展的不懈努力，将中国生态优势的金字招牌擦得更亮。
The flowing clear waters witness the unremitting efforts of China to achieve greater progress in promoting green development and gaining its ecological advantages.
坚决保护好中国的山山水水，推动经济社会发展全面绿色转型，加快建设美丽中国和生态文明强区。
We resolutely protect China's mountains and waters, promote comprehensive green transformation of economic and social development, accelerate the development of a beautiful China and a strong ecological civilization region.
努力走出具有中国特色的绿色发展之路，为“一带一路”建设做出贡献。
And strive to embark on a path of green development with China's characteristics.Making new contribution to the development of the Belt and Road Initiative.
好，谢谢大家聆听。以上是我分享内容分享，期待与大家有进一步的交流与合作。
Thank you very much for your listening. The above is what I want to share with you, and I hope to have further communication and cooperation with you.
谢谢老师，请留步。等一下，我们有这个学生问答环节，老师好，等一下啊。
刚刚念错。
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Ms. Yang, for wonderful production and presentation speech just gave us. You guys, wait a minute, please let's share just for.We're now heading to our Q&A part, interactive video lecture. So guys, do you have any questions relating to your presentation about we can have the chance to interact with our Ms. Yang. Finish line, you have any question is welcome.
Oh, 刚刚我有一页 PP 好像讲到这个问题了，有一页的 PP。
老师，这样。
学生有问题。
这个，嗯，对，出来了。
降
低能
然
后问怎么讲降低成本嘛，然后就是最主要是降低我污水处理厂的能耗。
Okay, the most important thing to reduce the cost of wastewater plant is to reduce the energy consumption of the wastewater plant. On tomorrow's lecture on the disposal and handling of sludge before it can be used as a natural fertilizer.
Okay, I got one question here. How do we ensure treatment operations comply with regulatory standards?
什么标准？
杨老师，黄老师，这个
我看一下。What are the materials that is good and effectively used for water filtration?对于水过滤用什么样的材料是好的，然后具有高效的
水过滤
的材料，什么样的材料是好的，要具有高效的性能。
那我要问一下，他是问的是饮用 是污水吧，污水还是饮用水？
So for the water filtration, you mean the wastewater or water for drinking water?
如果是污水的话，我们现在一般用的是石英砂，砂和石英砂，然后分级，就是用不同的粒径来做的。
Okay, if it is for wastewater, we usually use the coarse sands or sands, which is graded for the filtration of sewage or wastewater.
How do we ensure treatment operations comply with regulatory standards?
这不是刚刚那个问题吗？
就是我们能够怎么样能够确保我们的这个治理符合相关的标准要求？
那首先你有标准，第二你还要检测呀，
嗯，
进水和出水进行一个检测呀，嗯、然后你就是这个问题我可能是我没看明白，
嗯，
他是想问什么，怎么处理达标？
对，才能确保
那。反正就是我们现在目前的那个处理方法，就是刚刚那个 PPT 讲到的，
嗯、
就是用到的生物处理法。
嗯。
啊，就是用一级处理、
嗯、
二级处理、三级处理，记得那个吗？
嗯嗯、对。
啊，然后进行处理、
嗯、
啊，然后你一级、二级一般都可以达标了、
嗯。
一级、二级还不够的话，我们就用三度深度处理使它达标。
嗯。
嗯。
Okay, firstly, you need to have a national code or specification, and then we will conduct inspection or testing before or after the water goes into the water plants. And as I mentioned just now, that we have three kinds of treatment, the primary, secondary, and tertiary treatments. Usually, the primary and secondary treatment will achieve the standard requirements, but if they are not achieve the requirements, we will use the tertiary treatment, which is the advanced treatment, to make sure that it complies with the requirements of the standard.
Thank you.
嗯，对，
哦，这是刚刚那个，你先问的这个。这个这是问题啊，不好意思。为什么一下就过了？这个动位置。
哦，这个没，刚才音频有问题，现在也好了。Is there any international boom may use as basis in applying the standard procedure for equipment containment system? International boom.
我在想一个事情，同学们现在还录他们，我可以问一下同学们还录他们的吗？还录同学们的吗？
什么？
就是我还录同学们吗？
啊，现在不录了，现在。
那
我们稍微轻松点，自由点，但是一样保持课堂纪律。
啊啊啊啊！
我杨老师大概等一下再回答一两个问题的时候，我就跟他们说，因为时间有限，咱们再去回一个或两个问题就结束这个。
嗯嗯。可以，好的，谢谢。
Okay.
然后这一个就是啊，你的那这是什么？
这个
对，
不太清楚它是什么意思啊？没
有。
May use as a basis in applying the standard procedure。
这个 BOM 是什么意思啊？
他这个用在可能用错了还是什么？打错了，可能跟电脑说什么？
对啊。
再说。
暴涨？什么鬼？
他可能问的是在使用。这个废水系统的时候有没有一个国际标准来作为基础？
我们目前是反正执行的是中国的那个标准，
嗯
嗯、我目前执行的是这一个，
嗯、
这个叫做中国城镇，这、
嗯、
是你翻译过的，
对，
中国城镇什么什么标准来的？你的名称有点长，我也瞄一眼下。
Okay, sorry guys, due to time limitation, we'd love to answer all of your questions, but as time runs out, we will be a little picky on selecting questions. Like, we can only answer one or two more questions, and then we should move to the next part. Thank you. So, Ms. Yang and our interpreter will select one or two questions.
Okay, let me answer this question. That is there any international, I think it's an international regulation used as basis for complying with the standard or procedure of equipment in conducting the wastewater equipment. So far, we have not international standards, and we
what we apply is a Chinese standard, which is the standard for discharge of sewage pollutants from urban and rural areas. That is a Chinese standard, not an international one. The smart water management platform, it helps to do lessen water shortage and why it's called smart water treatment. 就是智慧水管理系统平台能够有效的缓解城市缺水问题吗？然后为什么能够日本把它叫做智慧管理系统？
它只是一个管理系统，
嗯，
不能，它只是一个管理系统，它可以实时监测啊，比如说雨洪啊，哪里的这一个指标啊，各个地方的指标，那些专有名词我也不会。那可以监测这一个管网液位流量水质，它主要是一个监测，但是它联动之后呢，可以使我们这一。
Okay. The smart water management is not something that is used to address the shortage of water in urban areas, but based on the information it provides, such as the level of pipelines and operation flow, this kind we can use it to manage to have better manage of the water supply. This treatment be used to generate renewable energy. 废水处理能够用来生产可持续的能源吗？或者可更新能源？
这个问题问的好大呀！
杨老师，您觉得精力够了，累了就可以暂停回答。就最后一个问题也行。
换一个。
就是穿着这是一个，对，那这种。
这个有个长长的。
乌干达的学生，然后在 Guru University， how plants can be controlled as part of the national participation？
这是物理啊。物理每天都每天不是会回答吗
？Okay。Okay, this question, because today we are talking about the wastewater or sewage, not a sludge. Sludge will be discussed tomorrow. Thank you for your question, sir.
Okay, guys, we are moving to the next part. Let's turn on your camera, please. Let's take a photo together. Yes, wonderful.Everyone, please turn on your camera. We're getting there. We're getting to have your, attendance sheet and everything ready. Yes, David, you look nice. Nice to meet you too. Everyone, please hold on. We still got the people opening their cameras now.Alisa, 帮忙截一下。你方便吗？
那我截，摁一下那个 printer 是吗？他们的 share 三，没见有截屏出来呀、啊、？Ctrl Shift 三。
Okay, we will be set in.3, 2, 1, go. Thank you, everyone. One more, please. One more. Okay, you all look nice. You all look nice. 1, 2, 3, go. Okay, about the attendance sheet. So your certificate of participants will only be issued tomorrow.After our series of courses, the final one, the last one. So what we could do now, just fill in the links, the attendance sheet, but certificate will only be issued tomorrow. So tomorrow at the same time as today, we are having our last and the third lecture, sludge treatment and disposal. And of course, I assume most of you guys are getting a lot of interest in interacting and communicating with us. So if you want to follow our next move, our next event, please feel free to join our Telegram or WhatsApp. So everyone, let's say thank you to our interpreter and our speaker, Ms. Yang, today, and we might leave our room in order. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Send this link in the checkbox. Feel free to join our group chat.
好的，辛苦了。
Thank you. Remember to sign in the attendance link, or you cannot get the certificate tomorrow. Thank you, Mr. Magar. Mala, sorry.
他出现了。
Yeah, I saw.
你觉得不吗？觉得他的
歌。他说这个。
哦，那没事，结束就。你还在上课吗？因为我这边结束了，比较快，比想象的快。你要过来调试吗？好的，可以。或者你这里，他这里不是有你的 PPT 吗？还是你更新过？
Please remember to find the attendance link.
那你发给我吧。那发给我。
And if you want to get the PowerPoint of the lecture, you can join the group chat to get the PowerPoint. Thank you.
好的。那你发给我吧。对，他说他想调设备，然后但是他现在在上课，他发给我，然后因为他是英文的那个备注，他想看一下效果。他刚加的，因为
或者是我们到时也可以拿。
对，还是
看
没有，对，还是顺便调一下吧，省得明天你看早上半个小时也都搞得杠杠的。
Please fill in the link. The room will close in about 5 minutes.
没有什么。
那行呗，那我各位同学写辛苦了，今天在这里听了一下。
The links are the same.